They're called negotiations for one reason. You negotiate back and forth with the employees and with the city. Mr. Stinson went in with a plan to pick apart a contract that's been in place for, since I didn't put the other one in place. I wasn't here to put that one in place or anything like that. I wasn't in any negotiations or anything. And plus, the firemen actually only took 6 months of retro. The police had 1 year. It started from January 1st. The firefighters actually had it from July 1st for retro. It's a huge win for the taxpayers of Brigantine. It might not happen today, might not happen tomorrow, but this is a long-term solution to a problem everybody wants to keep on pointing the fingers at. And I think Mr. Stinson, the police officers, the firemen, did a heck of a job negotiating. They gave up a lot. So this was a huge win for the city of Brigantine, for every taxpayers that pay their taxes. It stabilizes it, just like our debt, so we don't have to go up and down. And we would not got that in negotiations with outside attorneys involved. We got it under 2%. I think it's so the best contract the city of Brigantine for the taxpayers got in a long, long time. Maybe back when I had hair. That's best, you know. So to sit here and just kick this fireman and police and everything, God forbid any one of you guys call up 911 and those guys there, and they're worth every dime they have. Thank you.
Let me just, Andy, I wasn't going to respond until that last comment. You couldn't resist that, I guess. No one, not Mrs. Phillips, not me, when we were voting and discussing the contract, not anyone who I've ever seen come up to that microphone has ever questioned the professionalism, the expertise, the ability, or the commitment of either the police or fire. That has no role in the discussion, and it's a cheap shot for you to throw that in. The discussion that I initiated when we voted on the contract was a discussion that I said we needed to have because we have never had it. We have never had any discussion that looks at the totality of the contract. And I know you want to focus, because it suits your purpose, on the fact that there was an existing contract, and in your view, arbitration would have cost money, and they would have gotten the 2% instead of 1.9, and we wouldn't have gotten any other givebacks, and that the extension of the steps was, you know, so valuable. You know, if we do it the next four contracts, maybe it will be. If we don't increase the salaries for the next four contracts, maybe
okay,
it
we'll
will
get
be.
Back arbitration too. And, so I mean, Rick, you're brutal with this. Sky is falling, and yeah, you never have a solution.
Yeah, no, I have a solution. Andy.
No, you don't.
I've had a solution.
You sit here and complain and don't have a solution to nothing.
Andy, all you do is you give your pitch. All the time, you give your political pitch and your spin.
You're I sat here my and, political
Andy,
pitch.
I gave numbers, data from the contract. I asked simple questions. Question one, why did we throw on two additional days off? Do you know what the cost of that is each year? Two entire shifts, basically free new holidays. If the average cost per shift is in the neighborhood of 1,000, and it is, that's 2,000 a man, 60,000 a year, right there. What? Why do we have, now, there might be a perfectly good reason, but I asked the question, you know it because you were in the back room when I asked it, what does the clothing allowance cover if we're already providing shoes and uniforms? Maybe there's something it covers, I don't know. I'd like to hear that, I didn't hear it. That's $1,000 a man, there's 30,000 each year. And in terms of the vacation time, I know you want to start, because you did it before, and I'm sure you'll do it in the next contract if we're still around. You'll always want to talk about, well, you can't really do anything with the contract you used to have. Well, let's start with at least talking about it so we know what is the magnitude of the numbers that we're talking about. When, and I went through it last time, it's an extraordinarily rich contract. The fact that the last contract may have been comparable and the contract before that really doesn't change that fact at all. I mean, you can't put all the weight, and yet you do, on the fact that, wow, if you go to arbitration, you're doomed. Well, I'm not so sure about that. And the cost of arbitration, what do we think it would be? 30,000 for the lawyer, maybe? And maybe you go from 1.9 to 2%. Well, what's the magnitude of that change? It went from 1.9 to 2%. You're talking about a couple thousand bucks.
In your expert opinion, you think you would got the guide?
I don't need to have an expert opinion on it, Andy. I need to, as a council person, have the discussion. We did it in a way that was absolutely inimical to the public having any ability to meaningfully comment on it. And at the end of the comments, if the majority of the people up here feel it's a good contract and great for the city, then you vote for it as you did. But I don't think that's proper at all to be basically berating Mrs. Phillips or anyone else for asking the questions. You know, we're here with that contract that you say you can only nibble away at the edges, whether you're right or you're wrong. We're here not because of accident, not because some mysterious third parties forced it on us. That is the conscious product of negotiations year after year. There's a reason why the firefighters are only going to be in the first years of contributing to healthcare. That's because in 2010, police didn't get this, public works didn't get this, white collar didn't get this, but the firefighters got a brand new contract 5 days before the law took effect that they would have to contribute. Do you know what the magnitude
Rick,
of that
I can't
is?
Help what happened in 2010. And I can only help what happened in 2015.
Right, and I'm talking about, and I want to have the context out there, when I talk about the contract in 2015, and when other people talk about it, I don't divorce that from the past. I don't say, okay, that's the hand we were dealt, let's look at it. I say look at the totality. And if in looking at the totality of it, you feel comfortable in saying it is the greatest contract ever for the taxpayers in the history of Brigantine, that's fine. You could say that. But let's not try and, A, squash discussion of alternative views, or B, as you did at the end there, throw in the, well, God forbid you should ever have to call 911. That's got no place in the discussion ever.
Well, Rick, again, in your expert opinion, you think you would get all the stuff you sit there and complain about.
Would I have to get all of it, Andy? No. I know that when we started negotiations with both the police and the fire unions, and that was under a prior administration, day one, there was a demand from the city side for extended salary steps. So that was always there. That was our starting point. Did we, as it played out, apparently discuss anything else? I don't know. I'm not going to talk about what happened in negotiations, A, because I wasn't at the table, and B, if it was told to me in the back room, I'm not going to talk about that here. But the end product is the end product. Well, and if people have a question about it and they want to know, you know, how does this add up? What does this mean in dollar terms? What does it mean? And it's a legitimate question because it affects us in today's contract as well, that there was no contribution for 4 years to health care.
Three new firefighters over the life of their career, with those steps in there, with longevity out of there, will save taxpayers close to $1 million.
And how much would it cost, Andy, how much would it save the taxpayers if we negotiated two fewer weeks or X number of shifts, fewer vacation or sick time? And those are numbers that I point out because if somebody can show me differently that I'm wrong about this, that there are other examples outside of Atlanta County paid firefighters or police where you get that number.
Well, you get another bite at the apple in a year or two, Rick.
No, you don't get another bite at the apple. And your approach,
you're trying to get the whole apple at once.
No, that's just wrong. But
no,
you want to keep saying, keep saying.
Well, I negotiate every day. I negotiate with unions every day.
Any of your unions, Andy, get that many days off for sick and vacation?
A lot of union guys get days off, and they make a lot more money than a lot of these firefighters and police officers.